What's going on? How's everyone doing?
Shout out to you, Colin. Everybody else who's cool with Colin.
Chucky! I didn't say.
Eat your popcorn. And your Coca-Cola and relax.
Anyway, tell Colin. I'm rich.
What's going on? This is Colin. I hope you guys are having a great day so far. I've got two different sovereign citizens, two different courts. We have Judge Washington, we have Judge Simpson, we have Eric Martin, and we have the construction worker sovcit. I think his last name is Day, but every time he says it, I think Bay, you know, because it kind of goes hand in hand. All right. Both of them are returning. Yeah, we know who Eric Martin is at this point. The construction worker sovcit in front of Judge Simpson. Know who that guy is at this point as well. I'm rambling. Before I hit that play button, you know what to do. Hit the like and subscribe. Do your jump kick backflips. Let's go.
State of Michigan versus Eric Martin, case number 23S00425.
We're definitely for the people.
Citizens Public Defender Sandra White as standby counsel.
Thank you.
So, can you hear me?
Yes, I can.
All right.
One moment, please. I can't figure out how we got on this. How we got on the phone.
All right. While Judge Washington's looking over her paperwork, Eric Martin has been released from jail, it appears. He made his bond. I don't remember what it was. I think it was $1,000. I think that's what it was. But apparently he's been released. He's back in the confines of his own home. It looks like the same room he's always been in. So I don't know how his no contact's going with his sister right now. But anyways.
Oh. Oh.
Oh, I thought I timed that perfectly.
Okay. All right. We're here for a final settlement conference today. And where are we with this matter, please?
Your Honor, I believe that we were previously ready to proceed actually directly to jury selection, but I think that it may have been set for final settlement. Mr. Martin had some other matters in some other courts, and I don't know if he missed a date or something in there that had it.
I'm not sure how he got put on for final settlement conference. It was supposed to go directly to jury selection, but we're here. Mr. Martin? You're still requesting a jury trial in this matter, sir?
Yep.
All right. We already have it scheduled for jury selection on August 9th at 8:30 a.m.
8:30 right now. Something new I'm going to say is I'm going to demand appointment of counsel, even though I know you already had him in standby. I always was refusing him, but since it's being fraudulently assumed I'm the defendant anyways, along with all the other fraudulent presumptions. I'm going to go ahead and take the lawyer, but again, I'm not agreeing to no fraudulent presumptions that may normally attach to that, such as I'm a defendant, I'm a ward of the court, et cetera, et cetera. I can go on and on, but you know, under canon law 3228, for example, and et cetera. But so yeah, I want to make that clear on that. And also there's some pretrial demand to dismiss I made that haven't been ruled on yet. They should, because they're, you know, pretrial, they're matters of law. So they should be ruled on before trial. And
Lord have mercy.
All right. Just look at Judge Washington and Ms. McDuffie. Also at the defense attorney, Sandra White. Yeah, all three of them are just like, stop talking, man. You just asked for an attorney. And I think when he said that, all three of them just wanted to stand up and just applaud. It's like, yes, we can finally get this case going. No, they're still looking annoyed as ever, which I would too if I were them. But good job asking for an attorney. Let's see how well that works for you.
Yeah.
I'm sorry, Your Honor. I wasn't trying to interrupt, but I just wanted to thank Mr. Martin for that update and to say that his counsel that he's now requesting, if the court chooses to appoint them, formal to this case, will be probably happy to assist with all those things, because we have to do jury selection, instructions, and I was going to ask how I need.
All right, I know I'm pausing a lot. His counsel is going to be happy to assist. Look at Sandra White right now. Just look at her. Yeah, she's so happy to assist him.
To communicate about it.
Well, with respect to any pretrial matters, this court did make a ruling on the record, and I have a written, I wrote it down in my notes here as to each ruling I made on each of the issues. So that has been addressed. If you are expecting counsel to be appointed, sir, at this point in time, then I will do that. And after that point, you will no longer be able to speak on your own behalf. You understand that?
No, I do not understand. I do not agree with that. That is totally violation of my due process rights. I object to that. Regardless of what the counsel may say, I still have the Constitution right to say what I want to say is a First Amendment right. So if you're going to say I must accept counsel and must violate, with the condition that I must violate my own constitutional right to speak when I want to and have a right to speak, then I'm not accepting it. But
that is your choice, sir.
So what's it going to be? Are you going to tell me, are you still going to stick with that or what?
I was very clear on what I said.
Okay, well, I'm going to forget. Then I'm going to, like I said, I'm going to change my mind on that. Then if I'm going to violate my own constitution right to speak.
All right. Then, as you go through the jury.
All right. Yeah. Eric Martin's audio has always been terrible. The best audio he's had was when he was in jail. Yeah, it's just how it is. Yeah, told you. He withdrew that real quick. Right quick. Real right quick. I love words.
Election process in any of these processes, you will be held to the same standard as any other attorney in a case, because that is what the law and the court rules require. So if you're in violation of those rules, sir, then what is going to happen is you will be held in contempt of court like any other individual would if you are not, in fact, following the rules of court. Do you understand, sir?
Objection. That violates the Supreme Court case law. I can't think of the name of it right now, but I have read it before years ago that non-official attorneys are not to be held to the same standards as attorneys.
Mr. Martin? That is not the law, again, and I have told you what is going to happen. So I will see you here on August 9th at 8:30 a.m. Prepare to go to trial. See you then. Have a good day.
Your Honor, I'm sorry. I do just have one quick question.
All right. Eric Martin just dipped out. This clip's almost over, but I wanted to make a quick point. That is the first time I've ever heard that argument, that non-official attorneys do not need to be held to the same standards. We need to look that up. Someone needs to research that. I'll try to look it up. But yeah, that's an interesting point. It's not true, but it's an interesting point. So there, generally every sovcit argument has, some, fact of being true at one time, and then they just don't read the rest of what they're citing it. So I'm interested to know what he just cited, so I'll look it up. All right, let's finish this one up.
Question. He can be going.
He's gone.
But I just need to ask the court, because we have to submit the jury instructions and et cetera, I don't have email contact information from Mr. Martin. I don't know if he uses email. So I can submit that to the court, and I guess.
He has standby counsel, so submit it to his counsel.
We'll do.
Bond is continued.
Oh man, the looks on those three faces. Sandra White, Miss McDuffie, and Judge Washington. That trial is not gonna be on Zoom. It's not gonna be on YouTube. I need to find out when that is. I may make my way up to where is she? She's in Ypsilanti, right? Yeah, I gotta stop saying Yip. I was told I say that incorrectly. You do not pronounce the Y, it's Ypsilanti. I think that's where she is. I need to make my way up there for that trial. All right, next one. This is the construction worker sovcit that's in front of Judge Simpson. This is a short one. I'm really glad that both these happened back to, like, almost right back to back. This guy came in front of Simpson, and then Eric Martin was in Judge Washington. It worked out perfect for a video because both of them are really short, but two sovcits, two judges, two courts. Let's go.
Court calls the case. People versus Tariq Day.
He what? Okay.
No, well, you tell me how many people.
And I don't believe that our office is any longer connected to this number.
You don't believe that you are? Why? What? So? Well, yeah, but he's gonna tell me that.
You do.
You do. Oh yeah, you're on the case. Till I say otherwise. No, probably not gonna happen. Your name?
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you.
Your name?
Tariq Samar Tariq Ade.
Okay. All right. What are we doing in this case?
Oh, I'm still waiting for the hearing for the jurisdiction hearing. Put in the
for what?
The jurisdiction hearing. Put in a motion for a dismissal for lack of jurisdiction.
When did you put that motion in?
It's been, I'm not sure when it
did
was.
Did you file a written motion?
Yes. I didn't get a receipt or anything. They said you filed, they filed it in the, or at some time.
Have the people received a copy of a motion regarding jurisdiction?
No, in May, the last time a different prosecutor and your honor and everybody else was here, there was conversation on the record about the defendant having filed the motion. We're still waiting for the
competency. I don't have a competency report.
There's a quote we'd like to quote, Your Honor, in our files. And the quote is about how we will not be addressing this until the competency report is back.
Thank you.
And that it would have to go through his counsel.
And the other thing, okay, so that your counsel, I will give you an opportunity to look at it because I don't know what to make of it. He sent something to the court. Like an attempted to draw a check on the back of a birth certificate and then some notice of adequate assurance for performance and settlement.
That's awesome. That is awesome. It's awesomely stupid. What does Law Talk with Mike say? What did he used to say it all the time. Deliciously stupid. Or just deliciously something. I don't know. I don't know what he used to say. He might still do it, but deliciously awesome? I don't know. I don't know, but that would have been perfect right there. Ah, dude. All right. I have nothing else to comment about this. This video is about done. Like I said, two soft sits happened back-to-back, two different courts. You guys are awesome. Please hit that like button. I would really much appreciate it. I'm going to let it play out. Till next time. Bye.
Whatever. So we will give counsel an opportunity to look at that. I will adjourn this matter out for competency. I was giving what date? October. Talk to you.
October 20th.
They said that the competency hearing was on the 25th. I wasn't given any other information after that.
Say it again.
And I tried to ask him at the last hearing. It would be coming in the mail. And
October 24th, 2024. 9 a.m. If we get a report prior to then I'll move the date up.
Thank you.
Thank you. Counsel, we will let you look at that. Maybe we can, what we'll do is we'll just make copies of it.
Thank you.
Send it to you.
So what has happened is.
Thank you. Court calls the case, People versus Michael Jewell.